With COVID-19 cases dropping across the U.S. and with President Joe Biden expressing more optimism in the country's fight against the pandemic, it seems like some people, especially the youth, have also eased up on protecting themselves against the deadly disease. Over the weekend, videos and photos circulated online showing maskless partygoers in Florida already enjoying spring break as if the pandemic did not exist anymore.
We have seen footage of people enjoying spring break festivities maskless. This is all in the context of still 50,000 cases per day. Equally concerning are the resurgences we are now seeing in some European countries, countries that have had strikingly similar trends and surges during the pandemic as the United States. Each of these countries has had nadirs like we are having now, and each took an upward trend after they disregarded known mitigation strategies. They simply took their eye off the ball. I'm pleading with you for the sake of our nation's health. These should be warning signs for all of us.
Meanwhile, the CDC said it expects that the UK variant of COVID-19 will soon be the dominant variant by the end of March, and that's why getting vaccinated is so important. Nearly 70 million Americans have had at least one dose of the COVID-19 vaccine, and more than 37 million having been fully vaccinated. There are also discussions in the U.S. and other parts of the world of creating a vaccine passport, documentation travelers can show that they've been inoculated. But the White House COVID-19 response team said it's not the role of the government to hold that data.
It should be private. The data should be secure. The access to it should be free. It should be available both digitally and in paper and in multiple languages. And it should be open source. So those are the right kind of principles for someone to be able to have, be able to demonstrate that they have had a vaccine. And we know that there are efforts that are underway led by nonprofit collaboratives and the private sector, all working on exactly that type of thing.
The U.S. continues to see rates of new COVID-19 cases drop, with only 38,000 new cases reported in the last 24 hours, representing a 19% decrease in the last 2 weeks. In terms of deaths, there were only 572 new deaths within one day, reflecting a 31% plunge. In total, the U.S. is still inching closer to 30 million COVID-19 cases since the start of the pandemic, with more than 535,000 lives lost.